Good day, namaste, ashe, my love bugs, my flames, my lions and lioness, my flames of truth. How y'all doing? I'm doing okay, okay? I'm doing okay. I'm trying to, because I know shifts be going on, be a lot of shifts and shit, so I'm shifting with the shifts, and I'm doing okay, you know? This matrix, I'm telling you, it just... It's just, you get fed up with this bullshit, all right? You just get tired of it after a while. Ben got tired when I had my awakening like 5 years ago. And I'm, you know, that was 2016, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. It's 6 years, about to be 7 years. Next year is going to be my seventh year. Hopefully I'll be the lucky year next year. The seventh year on my awakening journey, you know? Hopefully that year, next year, it be so fucking amazing than any other motherfucking year, because that's, you know, lucky seven. And, you know, I just decided to make a video right now, because, yeah, I know it's Twin Flame Tuesdays, but we coming on later. We coming on later. I was just so frustrated, guys. Like, I'm just tired of people getting, you know, trying to get over on people and when they really need their help, you know? Like, I got my account hacked, my Instagram account, I'm trying to get it back. And then I paid this guy, he said he was going to help me get it back. He was sending me, like, screenshots that he got to the account, but listen, I don't know. I paid him, and I feel like he's scamming me. And I'm just like, I'm just done, you know? I'm just, that's it. I'm not sending no money to nobody else for no fucking services. I don't give a fuck if they, I don't care what it's for. I don't care what the fuck it's for. I'm not doing it, because every time I try, you know, to, I can't trust nothing to nobody. I know that, but like, I don't know how people could be so fucked up, you know? Say they're gonna do whatever. So anyway, I don't want to keep talking about that, because y'all know that shit really doesn't matter. Like, it really does. It matters, but not really, you know, because that's not a part of, you know, your journey. That's not like, oh, the ancestors and the spirit guys gonna be like, well, your Instagram had a part to do. Like, what about that account? You understand? Like, that shit don't fucking matter, really. And it's, you know, I just want it to be shut down, or I want the hacker, you know, to fucking get hit by a fucking train, bitch. Cause like, you did that to me. You understand? Like, that you fucking with me. The ancestors have to, and the spirit guys, they have to, and Roya, my mother, go fuck this hacker up. Like, stop this hacker in their tracks. Cause they pretending to be me asking people for money and they import information, and people, you know, they know it's not me, but then some people don't know it's not me. You know, so hopefully this shit stops. Just, you know, I don't care about getting a page back or nothing. I just at least shut the shit down. Shut it down, deactivate it. Person need to fucking get hit by a fucking car, bitch. Train, bus, so, all right? I don't care. You don't do shit like that to people. Like, I never thought it would happen to me. I was being so fucking stupid. But anyway, okay, I want to keep talking about that. Because like I said, that's just, you know, something, some mix-up in my life. You know, it's not like somebody hacked my website, you know? I still have my website. And they didn't hack my email or... You know, they didn't hack nothing else, just that. So thank God, you understand? Because I had to change my passwords and everything. So that's the only thing that was hacked. But I still, like, don't pretend to be me asking people for shit. Okay? So anyway, that's that. That's just, you know, that needs to get resolved. But other than that, guys, let's move on. Okay? That's just that fucking one piece of shit right there. It's just, ugh. Okay, but anyway, hopefully we can, you know, the ancestors, the universe can fix this right here, because it's bothering me, all right? But I'm trying to distract myself to not, you know, keep thinking about it. But I'm just like, Instagram is full of shit. Can't even contact fucking support. All right. All right. Let's keep going. Let's keep moving. It's just so fucked up. So anyway, I want to talk about my divine masculine now, right? But I gotta let y'all know how I feel and things of that nature. You know how I feel and what's going on in my journey. I've been, you know, I was down, and sometimes I have those days when I'm down. You know, either just life itself, this fucking matrix, or just, you know, my twin flame pisses me off or something like that. Okay? But I want to talk about him because I did Divine Masculine Mondays yesterday, and I spoke a little bit about, you know, my updated journey, but I didn't get a chance to, you know, because I didn't want to make the video too long. So, I said I'm going to do a separate video. So, this video is going to be about my divine masculine. Yeah, no, I love talking about him. I love talking about him, and I love talking about twin flames, period, okay? I love talking about the journey, twin flame. I love talking about. I just love talking about it. You understand? You know, certain things you don't want to talk about. Like, I don't want to talk about nobody fucking news, bitch. Don't want to talk about no news, and I don't want to talk about no celebrities. All right, but if you do want to talk about them, we can, because I can tell you who's living and who's dead and who's wearing a mask and who's not. Okay, so I have knowledge in each aspect of the bullshit matrix and the spiritual shit. All right, you have to know everything. So, yeah, guys, it's my medicine, because I'm telling y'all, my life, bitch. You going to smoke a split, or you going to fucking catch a case, bitch, because I'm telling you, motherfuckers, they be asking for it. Okay? And nobody got time for that. We got shit to do. It's raining, guys, out here in New York. Okay, so my divine masculine came over. He came over Sunday, right? He came over Sunday, guys, because he didn't come see me. And this is the first Sunday he ever fucking came to see me, bitch. Like, I swear to God, this is the first Sunday he ever came. As I'm thinking about talking to y'all, he never fucking came to see me on nobody's Sunday. He spent the night to Sunday. You understand? Like, he'll come on a Saturday, and he'll spend the night to Sunday, and he'll leave Sunday afternoon, you know, Sunday evening. But he never came on a Sunday. And it's like every time he come, he has this, you know, he don't want to leave. He got to spend the night, you know? Because he said he was going to come over, and he was like, oh, you know, he's going to leave at 3 o'clock or whatever. I don't know why he was fucking lying, bitch. Right? And that motherfucker did not leave anybody 3 o'clock, bitch. He stayed with me for almost like half of the day, you know? And I was just like, I was so happy. Because I hate, like, when he's about to leave, bitch. I hate that. I just can't wait till we live together. You understand? I can't wait till we live together. And I don't have to be, I won't be sad or, you know, crying when he leave, because I know he's coming back home, you know? So I can't wait to that feeling when he leaves, and I know, you know, like, bitch, he's coming right back. You know? So I can't wait for that. So he said by the end of this year, we're going to be, you know, living together. So who fucking knows, you know, we just got to wait and see, because you can't, bitch, I'm not even listening to his words, okay, I'm listening to his actions, because I ain't no rush, because the year's almost ended anyway, you understand? The year's almost ended anyway, so, you know, only time will tell, and I will see if he's telling the truth or not, because we only got, what, 3 more months left in this year? So I'm gonna know, you understand? Like, babe, like, you fucking, you understand? Because I'm gonna tell him, he gonna have to move with me, or, bitch, I'm telling you, it's gonna be a fucking problem. I'm telling you guys. Live with me, move with me, or he could go live with his fucking friends, his buddies, and go see how that work out for his ass. Okay? Because I told him he has to start inviting me places with him, you know, inviting me out when he go out. You understand? It's not, I'm telling you, he's not single. You're not single no more. You're not by your fucking self. You with me, invite me out. Okay? And if your Devon Lasker is not inviting you out, then you fucking need to, you need to tell him he need to, or he could go fuck off. That's it. That's it, and that's motherfucking all. All right? Oh, my goodness. Hold on, guys. Hold on. So, hopefully he get it right. If he don't want to get it right, bitch, then he's going to have to just fuck off. I said, I'm not telling him nothing. This is between me and you guys. This is between me and my YouTube friends. If he don't want to shape up, he's going to ship his ass out, all right? But, nah. Serious. If he don't want to, all right, invite me out. Whatever he doing, you know, we could chill, hang out with me. You know, I want to spend time. I'm not calling him, I'm not texting him, guy. He could go have fun. All the motherfuckers that's giving you attention, paying you mind, go fucking have fun with them. That's what the fuck is going to happen, because I'm not doing it, guys. All right, I'm so serious. I'm not going to keep preaching and shit to him. I'm not. All right, I'm not going to keep preaching and teaching to this man, because guess what? It's not going to be worth it. Guys, I'm gonna talk to y'all like this, you know. So anyway, hold on, guys. Right, so when he came over, you know, we was talking and stuff like that, and I told him, you know, I was kind of, it seemed like I'm always mad at him. I told him, like, I was, you know, a little bit mad at him, and you know, I just told him how I felt. And he was fucking acting stupid, like he don't know what the fuck I'm talking about at first. Like, where, what, why, how, bitch, you know what the fuck I'm talking about. Okay? Hold on, guys.
Okay, so I'm just like, stop acting stupid. You understand? Like, you know what I'm talking about. This motherfucker's a real character. Actor. He can be a fucking actor, I'm gonna tell him. Anyway, so, you know, whatever. So, we was talking, whatever, whatever. And, you know, and, we just was talking, watching, you know, videos, YouTube videos. I showed him the documentary by Dr. Eugene Adams, Asians, Africa and Asians. And, you know, so I would be teaching him, showing him things. He was showing me, you know, some things, too, that he'd be watching. And, you know, we was just talking, vibes and chilling. We fucking, we made love, like, 5 times. We made love, like, 5 times, bitch. I don't even fucking know how many times, but too many. All together, bitch, or really, really, bitch, I should have been pregnant, like, fucking 2,500 times already. But anyway, guys, so I'm just starting to see, like, he's being more open, you understand, with me. He's being more open, like, oh my goodness, it's beautiful. I love it. You know, we fucking, you know, we been eating together, but I could eat. I don't feel nervous around him. Some, you know, all the time. Sometimes I do. Sometimes, yes, I do. Right? But not no more like how I used to. Like, I used to be nervous to eat around him. And, you know, pass gas and use the bathroom. And, bitch, I'm so used to this man. I could pee with the door open. I could take a dunk. I could fart, bitch, now. You understand? I could pass gas. Like, I could be myself with him. And I told him that. I was like, babe, you know, I was like, we are so comfortable with each other now, you know? Far as in, like, he comfortable with me, but he not really comfortable as yet, like, far as talking to me, telling me stuff. Because he think it's going to hurt me. And, you know, and it's not going to hurt me. It's going to actually heal me. Help me. And, you know, and before at my old house, when we used to wake up, he used to face the wall. I used to face the TV. And we used to get up. I used to put the cover over my face, my mouth, and hide from him. Now, I wake up, bitch. I have crust in my eye. My breath could be stinking. He don't care, bitch. Like, yeah, I kiss him. He'll kiss me. Oh, my goodness. Like, I even wipe his eye if he has cold in it. You know, I never used to do that. And he used to get up and watch, you know, just go in the bathroom or whatever. Like, we never faced each other when we got up. You know what I'm saying? We was hiding and shit. And, you know, and we never used to talk like that. And he used to be silent and just, you know, so many unspoken words. So now we are talking, we are looking at each other, we are just saying what we feel, and I like that, you know. And I know I'm a lot to deal with, but that's how I know he's my twin flame, because he's putting up with me and I'm putting up with him, you know. He put up with my shit, I put up with his shit. I told him that, he told me that, I told him that. We put up with each other bullshit. You know, even though my shit is not bullshit, I just be going off the shit what he do. I just react to how he acts, you know, when he ignores me and ghosts me. Eric, we start acting away. But I'm a good girl. I don't cause no problems in a relationship. Okay, only if you not talking to me or something like, I mean, yeah, ignoring me, not talking to me. Then we have a problem. But, you know, he's not leaving me. You know, even no matter what I think, you know, what I have thought in the past, he always told me, you know, that he told me that's a long, long, long time ago, years ago, you know, like he not let go. He never letting go. But I didn't really, you know, I didn't really think he was serious. And I told him, I'm not going to let go. Because it's a song like that. Me not let go. Me not let go. So we were saying that song, that verse to the song to each other. And he never lied about that. That's one thing. He never lied about leaving me.
Hey guys, sorry, I'm back. All right, so he didn't lie about that. He never left me. I mean, he do leave, but he always come back. He always come back, but that's another reason I know he's my divine masculine. I don't know what that means, my divine masculine. This video is not about that. I already have a video about how I know he's mine's. But I need maybe I should make another one, an up-to-date one. Because there's so many other signs and synchronicities, you know? That I've been getting, confirmations I've been getting. And I'm just like, okay. Y'all can't fuck with the twin flames, no way. Nah. Okay? But I'm just like, okay, I know this is me. And then, like, even, like, I told y'all, like, my body was, like, trembling and shaking around him when we together. You know, just sitting on the bed. I'm shaking. And then, like, you know, my body. And then we laying next to each other. He, like, taking a nap. He's sleeping or whatever. And his body is jumping, like. Nah. But his body was, like, jumping. You know, like, he was shaking. And I'm like. That's crazy. Like, we both are shaking and trembling. And I'm right next to him, so I kept touching him to let him know, his body know, like, I'm here. You understand? I'm right here. I'm not going nowhere. And we had an intense moment. We always have an intense moment, but not this time. It was last week he came, right? I can't tell y'all every part of the detail, like, because some stuff you got to keep private. It's sacred and secret, okay? But I just tell y'all, you know, on the surface part, I'm not going to get too personal and deep, because some sort of stuff is just between me and him, you know, and the universe. So, you know, we were just kissing or whatever like that, you know, passionately kissing. I love kissing him. I swear to God, I could just kiss him all day, right? So we just kissing. No, at first we just lay in there, right? And you know, we about to go to sleep, but not really, but like going about to go to sleep because we just finished doing it. So we just lay in there, he holding me. And I'm just like, you know, it was not right after. It was like probably like 30 minutes after, I don't fucking know, but right after you have sex with him, you want it again, bitch. You just want it again and again and again and again and again. But yesterday, I kind of the first time, I think I didn't really, like, want it, because I think we just did it so much. It was just, like, I didn't even really want no more. I ain't gonna lie, okay? So that's the first time I felt like that, like, I was satisfied, like, I didn't need no more. Even when you satisfied the first time, you still want to be satisfied again and again. Because you're going to always be satisfied, right, with your twin flame. But I don't know. I just started wanting him more, bitch. And I'm like, he right here. He just gave himself to me. right? And I want him again, bitch, that fast. So, I don't know, bitch. It's crazy. So, I'm just rubbing on him, touching on him, kissing him, his face or whatever. You know why he sleep? And then he wakes up and he said, you know, he said, what, babe? You know what? What's wrong? And I was like, babe, like, I want you. And we just started kissing so passionately. And I just bust out into fucking tears, guys. That was point I was trying to make. All right, it was so passionately, we was kissing and I fucking started crying like fucking waterfall. And it wasn't, and it was so crazy because we kissing and I started crying, right? And I told y'all about this in other videos. This is not the first time, this is like probably like the fifth time, guys. You understand that I cry when we are being intimate with each other. Because usually I probably cry, like, if he leave or something. Right? Because I'm just thinking about my old house. I was crying one time when he was leaving. And he was like, why are you crying? He's like, you make me feel bad, you know? Whatever, but... That's how I know I love him so much. I fucking cry. I'm crying like I'm hurt. You understand? And I'm happy that he's there. Like, I'm not. I'm hurt, like, deep down inside. You understand? Like, you know the shit that I've been through, go through with him. But that's not all of why I'm crying. You understand? It's so deep. But anyway, so I started, you know, crying while we was kissing and whatever. And he was just wiping my tears. And he told me, you know, baby, it's going to be all right. And I was just like, oh my goodness, like, he acknowledged that. You understand? Like, that made me just feel so special. That made me just think, like, yo, this is my fucking twin flame. Like, I been knew that. You understand? But, like, really, like, when you get those confirmations again and again, you understand? Like, not all the time, unless you doubt it. If I doubt it, I get them frequently. But if I just, you know, if I know and don't doubt it and I be like, embrace it. Then spirit was like, see, bitch, I told you. See, goddess, I told you. Have patience, you know, in divine time, and everything happens for a reason. And I'm starting to see that. I mean, I've been with seeing it, you understand, because I figure like this man never leave my life. You understand? He does ghosts. He does go and ghosts me, but he always comes back. Nobody else does that. You understand? And I wouldn't allow nobody else to do that anyway. But nobody else has done that. You know, they tried to. You know, they have tried to. But that was a karmic. Okay? And my ex, he probably was a soulmate. I don't think he was probably a karmic. Because my ex Trinidadian boyfriend, the one I was crazy about before, when I was 19, before I met my divine masculine, they kind of look similar too, but he's more lighter and he cut his hair. So anyway, I was crazy over him too. He looked so fucking good, right? He looked good, and he was West Indian. He was Trinidadian. I mean, he had an accent. He was tall. You know, like, tall guy, hair braid, whatever. I was, like, really attracted to him. And, he got some nice eyes. You know, whatever. Like, he's attracted, okay? The first time I saw him, I was fucking attracted to him. Okay? So, anyway, and he was attracted to me, too. whatever. So, but the thing with that, with the sex, it was not, he never went down on me, guys, okay? He never went down on me. We never kissed. He tried to kiss me, but I didn't really like kissing him. I didn't like his lips. We never kissed. We never kissed. He never went down on me. I never went down on him. And it was, he never really massaged me. He never did foreplay. he never, it wasn't never really passionate. You know, it was just like, oh, he want to stick it in, boom, 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 it's over. And I'm just like, what? This is it? Mm-mm. This can't be it. You understand? He was just fucking me. He wasn't making love to me. We wasn't, you know, we was not really having sex. Like, we was, but we wasn't. Because I'm thinking what I'm doing with my divine masculine now. Bitch, I was not doing that with him. The way I'm on him. You understand? Like, I was not like that with him. You understand? Plus, I was younger. I'm older now, but still. I was young when I met my divine masculine. I wasn't like that with him either before. You know? I wasn't like that with him. So, I'm starting to open up more and more like a flower. Yeah, so I'm just seeing a difference, you know. And then my daughter father, you know, that was, you know, I think he probably was one of my soulmates, you know, because we bring a child to this world, but we wasn't supposed to be together. And I'm just like, the sex, like, he made me come. Don't get twisted when he go down on me. That's one good fucking thing, okay, he did. That I was just like, wow, going crazy about. But then he wanted to take control and advantage of me. Like, he wanted me to listen to him. Like, I'm his child. So I was like, no way, Jose. Okay? But the sex was, it was good. My baby father. But with him, it was like draining. You understand? Like, it's like my divine masculine gives me energy. You understand? Like, I don't want to, you know, go to sleep. I do want to go to sleep. I do want to rest and lay there with him. But, like, if we was to, like, do it and just get up, you understand? I can get up and just, you know, my baby father, it just, like, sleep and being lazy, just laying there. He takes, you know, my energy. And he like, oh, you suck my energy dry. And I'm like, bitch, you doing that to me, bitch. Like, every time you come, you know, it's just, like, lazy energy. Like, oh, like, you don't want to do nothing, like, you know? And then he just started acting crazy after that, too. To everything. But it was okay. It was okay. It wasn't like how, like, it's not as how good it is, like, now. Like, when he went down on me, it was good. Don't get it twisted. When he went down, yes. Okay? But, like, having sex, like, he made love to me. But I don't know. With my divine masculine, it's like nobody don't compare. You understand? Nobody don't fucking compare to the love we make, how we make it, when we make it, the way we make it. The positions that we do, you know, and the feelings and the passion, you know, that we feel is fucking beautiful. Like, it feels so good, you know? And like, my soul, whatever, is deep, guys. But anyway, so I just see that, you know, it's a difference, okay? Like, with your twin flame and other people, you will see the difference, like, from your past relationships and the people you've been with, you know, to your twin flame. And nobody compares, guys. Like, I love him so fucking much, you know, and I told him this. I told him I'm in love with him. I asked him if he's in love with me. You know, before he left, he said yes, and I believe him because I asked him this a while ago at my old house, and he said no, he wasn't in love with me. He said he loved me, but he wasn't in love. But now he's saying he's in love, so I believe him because it's not like he's been said that, you know. So it had to take him time, and I know he's in love with me because, like, now I see, like, if we argue or if I'm mad at him, he's trying to fix it, you know, like. You know, he tries, if not right then and there when I need him to, you know, like Friday night when I hit him up, bitch, I can't hear from him. Saturday, I can't hear from him. But Sunday, you understand, I'm fucking, I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Like, you didn't spend no time with me Friday, Saturday, you been ignoring me, you understand? Now, and then I can't hear from you today. You understand? Like, what the fuck? I'm tired of this bullshit. Like, you understand? Because he know how much I love him. He know. From my sister, me and my sisters from the party I went to him talking to my friend. Like, he knows, you understand? So, I'm just like, get it right, bitch. Like, he went out, you understand, with his friend, chilling with his friend. And I know because, you know, I'm following his friends on Facebook, but I'm not going to be telling him, oh, yeah, I saw your picture, his pictures on Facebook, and then he's going to fucking probably tell him some shit, and then he's going to try to block me or block the videos, and that's going to be suspect right there. You understand? So it's like, stop playing. You know I know. Like, you can't hide nothing from me. You understand what I'm saying? You can't hide nothing from me. Like, even if I didn't see those videos, pictures, like, I know he was still out, whatever. You understand? Like, I don't care. What, like, yeah, guys, I was telling him. So I'm like, I'm in your life. You understand? I'm a part of your life. Act like it. You know, you not by yourself. You not single. You are with me. You know, why you fucking, you cannot be living your life without me. You can't live your life without me, bitch. That's how crazy, man. We gotta live our own separate journey, guys. You understand? You, of course. Yes, but still, like, I feel like union is close, is near. Because he is, you know why I'm saying that? Because I said this in my other video too. It's less of time that he is staying away from me. You understand? Before used to be, guys, I'm telling you, used to be like a year, right? From the beginning, a year. And then it'd be like 8 months, right? And then it'd be like 7 months, right? It's like a countdown. 6 months, 5 months, 4 months. So now, all right, now it been like, I say recently, the longest he have been away from me is about 2 months. Okay? About 2 months. That's the longest and most recent, not most longest, the most recent was 2 months, okay? So now we had got into an argument or whatever recently, right? A couple of weeks ago, last month, I think, when I went to his house. And we made up, but it been a week. It only been a week, guys. You understand? So look at fucking that. It went from what? 2 months from a week, bitch, because he was like, don't ever talk to him again. You know, this is what he told me. He said, don't ever talk to him again. Even though he told me this before. He's like, he don't want to hear from me. And, you know, and he was just talking to me like he never spoke to me before, like talking to me crazy. And I didn't like it. And I was like, oh, shit, I never want to get him mad again. You know, but I'm just like, that, you understand, like, that happened on a Saturday, no, that happened on a Friday, yeah, right, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, he hit me up, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 6 days, okay? The sixth day. So it was like a week and 1 day. All right. He fucking hit me up and like, you home? And you know, and he said, you know, he want to come talk, bitch. And I was like, what? Is this my divine motherfucker masculine? Because that motherfucker never reached out, bitch, and said nothing about, oh, you want to come and talk? See? Because I said I wanted to come and talk. You understand? But that was a weak bitch. I thought when he said don't ever talk to him again, you don't want to hear from me, all this stuff. I thought we wasn't going to talk for probably, I couldn't even take it. That was a weak bitch. So picture was 2 weeks, like picture was to now. I don't even know, bitch. I will fucking manage. I probably think, oh, he probably got somebody else. You know, if it's that easy for him to let me go, bitch. But obviously, he don't got nobody else, guys. So, you know, and I love the fact that he was here and he was like, he don't got nothing to hide from me and stuff like that, because I was going through his phone and he didn't get upset. You understand? So, I'm happy, you know, he didn't, you know, get upset about that. And I'm happy he was trying to be a little open. He wasn't being fully open, but he was being open, telling me who's who, about his homegirls or whatever. And I still, you know, was telling him like, all right, but you need to let them know, put them in a place, let them know you got a woman, and you know, and they shouldn't be touching you or taking you out, nothing, no, none of that. You, that's all me, you know. And yeah, he was going through, I was going through his phone. He could go through my, I'm gonna tell him that, you know. I'm like, babe, you could go through my phone if you want to. I don't got nothing to hide. Okay. But yeah, he was saying that he don't got nothing to hide and things. And I'm just like, wow, like he never was like this, talking, being open, you know, even though you gotta have a couple of drinks first. Cause bitch, when he's sober, yeah, right. That motherfucker, you having like little attitudes and shit. Like, not really attitudes, but that, because I be having like little attitude, but not, I don't want to say attitude, but like little smart, little, I don't know, gestures. Like, he, because he's so fucking sexy, bitch. I'm just like, I don't even care when, like, if he, he making his face up sometimes, like, I think it's cute. I be like, look at my baby, he's so fucking sexy. Like, he looks so fucking good. Like, stop acting stink. Like, stop acting like that. Stop acting stupid before you get smacked. And he's like, why are you looking at me like that? You want to kill me? And I was like, no, because if I kill you, I'm going to miss you. You, I'm like, no, I don't want to kill him. He, sometimes he'd be like, I want to fucking kill him, but no, I'm going to miss him. Yeah, guys, it's raining outside. Rain a father. And love is on the brain. I am love. I am loving. I am lovable. Yes, Ashe. I just wanted to make this video, you know, a little quick video and let y'all know the rundown, the update, the what's up on my journey. My divine masculine is slowly but surely improving, guys. So, like, the last thing I left off with is, like, you know, it took a week for us to, you know, to make up. And, like I said, I thought it was going to probably be, like, a month, 2 months, whatever. But long, and it was, like, I was so happy. You understand? I was so happy. And it was so crazy because then my Spanish homegirl, she was like, oh, don't talk to him. Oh, don't let him come over and speak to see you, and watch, you know, saying he playing. So she was saying negative things, and then he reached out and he just showed me, like, otherwise, you know, like, don't listen to that shit. I love you. Like, we gonna fix this. And that's what I told him. We gonna fix this. We gonna work this out. You're not leaving me. You're not leaving me, you know. You're not leaving me, not going nowhere. You're not breaking up. So you gonna deal with it and fix it. And I think he realized that now. Like, you know, if I'm going to, like, waste my time, even though he not, but if I'm going to put up with some shit, if I'm going to, you know, I might as well just surrender and just, because she not going nowhere, you know. He realized if he run, he can't run, he can't hide, he can't ghost me, he can't, you understand, just, you might as well just deal with it, you know. If you're going to do that, you might as well do it with me. So I heard somebody say that on a post or no video. Or a post earlier. If you're gonna waste your time with people, you might as well waste it with the divine feminine, right? I think it was a video, whatever. But anyway. Yeah, guys, so he's just, you know, we ate together. We ate, we sat down, we ate, watched TV. I massaged him. He always massaged me, so I massaged him. You know, we was talking, we was eating. We was in the kitchen together. It was just, I don't know. It's just like we getting so comfortable. And then I told him that we getting so comfortable together. And I was like, babe, you see that? You know, just the difference. And he said, yeah. And certain things he was saying, like he called me an acrobat. Because the way I was like,